So this plant is commonly sold as Othonna capensis, but it's now moved into a new genus called Crassothonna capensis. And capensis, the species name, essentially means of the Cape. So that means the Cape provinces within South Africa, and that is where this is native to. Now, this one's called string of pickles or little pickle plant. This particular cultivar is called Ruby Cascade, and I think that's largely because of this kind of ruby purplish color of the stems. And you can see that this was just in flower, which is really lovely. It has, you could just see little bits of a little yellow flower. And the blooms are not, they're very subtle. They're not anything that's overly spectacular. People typically get this for its cascading habit and just the succulent nature of the plant and the way that it looks. Now, this is one that is definitely one that you could get for and be neglectful with. It likes to be on the drier side, so definitely give it a rockier kind of mixture it's a little bit more native to kind of that kind of craggy, rocky mixture. So I would say a lot more perlite, maybe even giving it a bonsai mixture within the succulent soil. Doesn't need a tremendous amount of humidity. You want to be able to water it, but again, the roots could rot very easily. So just be a little bit more mindful with the watering and make sure again that you have a little bit more of a porous mixture. Now I would recommend giving this a little bit more of top-down light if you could. I know it's more challenging when you have it growing in your windowsills, but it has a tendency to kind of like put all the leaves down below if you're not giving it top-down light and it gets a little bit more like bald spots. If that happens, then you could always cut them back and try to repropagate by taking some cuttings, and it should actually work that way. Although you might be feeling like you're doing a lot of like little hair plugs, you know, putting them in. And again, that just goes, happens. You know, it happens with some of these trailing plants, and that's just super normal, and you just have to get used to it or give it slightly different conditions. Now, as far as fertilizing this plant goes, stick with the succulent fertilizer. You could get away with like a biweekly and a monthly basis, a 247, 347, 011, anything along those lines. And yeah, otherwise it's a really rewarding plant to grow. I have this, and you might notice I have this in a terracotta pot, but it's like one of those ones that I think would actually grow well in a hanging basket. It's just that I don't have enough hanging basket space like within the area that I have the need the light for this plant. And this again is a plant that requires a little bit more light.